data engineering is one of the most prominent and highest paid jobs in the world right now. And many of the Fortune 500 companies are leveraging big data to make some important business decisions. So if you are also curious what is data engineering and how you can become one, then you have come to the right place. Hi, my name is Ashay. I'm a data engineer at Deloitte USA, and I'm going to tell you how you can become a data engineer and start your journey in the data world. So without further ado, let's get into it. So the first question would be, who is data engineer and what are their job responsibilities? So a data engineer processes the raw data and converts it into a more readable format so that the data scientists and data analysts can come to the conclusion and extract some meaning out of it. And it will be then consolidated, and the big companies can make important decisions by applying different type of analytics like predictive analytics, prescriptive analytics and so on. And data scientists can also apply some machine learning algorithms to get the wonderful output of that data. So you may ask, how you can become a data engineer? So there are some several steps you need to take to enter the world of data engineering, and that we are going to discuss now. So the first step would be, you should have the interest in the data engineering, because if you are just here for earning more money and you are just doing it because everyone is doing it and it seems to be the next big thing, then you are wrong. If you literally have an interest in data engineering and you like to learn how these big companies consumes this much time, who generates a lot of data and also do some analytics and extract some meaning out of it, then this sector might be interesting for you. Because at the end of the day, you have to extract meaning out of that data. And if you are not interested at all of what you're doing, then it doesn't matter how good are you in terms of programming skills, administrative skills, you will not succeed in this career path. So that would be the first point. The second point would be, you should be the active learner and you should have the hunger for learning new technologies. Because let's be honest, data engineering is a very evolving field right now, and it's not like you have to learn some 3 or 4 tools. There are new tools coming every day, and every new technology has some benefits on the other, and it totally depends on the application which tool is required for the particular use case. So if you are like, you will just learn 2-3 technologies and become a data engineer, that will not gonna work. You have to have the hunger for learning new technologies and how you can leverage it into your solution and evolve your data pipelines and your data engineering framework. Because some years ago, Hadoop was the biggest thing in the business, but nowadays Hadoop is becoming the history, and Apache Spark and cloud computing, NoSQL databases have literally replaced Hadoop ecosystem, not an entirely, but on a very large scale. And many companies don't even need Hadoop right now. But that doesn't mean that you don't have to learn Hadoop, because Hadoop is the very core for learning and entering the big data world. Because you should have the basic understanding of the distributed computing framework. So that comes to the next point, which is third point. You should have the basic understanding of the distributed computing. And let me tell you why it's needed. So if you are working for a big organization who generates and consumes a lot of data, and lot means terabytes of data, then you have to provide a very scalable solution which is highly available and fault tolerant. And for that purpose, there is only one thing which is mandatory if you're handling big data, which is distributed processing of that data. So therefore, you should have a very basic fundamental knowledge of how distributed computing works. So for that purpose, I'll highly recommend you to learn Hadoop ecosystem and their each component. That will be the base of your big data learning path. So we already have a dedicated playlist for learning Hadoop and all the technologies that can come under the Hadoop ecosystem. It has 59 lectures and 13 hours of content. So if you're interested in it, I'll give it in the description below so you can go through it. So if you're liking this video, please hit subscribe and also ring the notification bell to get latest updates. Now let's talk about the fourth part. And fourth part consists of the programming language. So you should have a good understanding and command on any of the programming language. And I'll highly recommend you to go and learn Python, because Python is out of the box, very easy to learn, very readable and a versatile language. So it's not like you should learn only Python. There are so many languages such as Scala, Java, R for data analytics, and they are also versatile. But as a Python developer, I love Python, and if you are new to data world, I'll highly recommend you to start with Python because it will be a good starter for you. Because Python will be needing to build Apache Spark application, which could be written in Python, as well as the Pandas, which is also a library for data analytics. And also you can do machine learning by using the mllib library of Apache Spark. And you can also integrate many technologies like GraphQL, NoSQL databases, as well as the OLTP databases using Python. And also you should be having a good understanding of SQL, and not just good understanding, but you should be a pro in SQL, and that will only come with practice. No matter what theoretical knowledge you know, if you don't practice SQL, it will not be enough in the data engineering world. You should have a good understanding of any programming language and SQL. That will be the fourth point. Now coming to the fifth point, you should have a good understanding of cloud computing. I'm not saying that you should be a cloud developer or you should know cloud administrative tasks, but at least you should be having a good understanding of how you can deploy your data pipelines into any of the major cloud platforms like Azure, GCP or AWS. And earning an associate level cloud certification related to the data engineering is also a very good thing, and it will be a cherry on top of the cake. So once you are good with any of the programming language as well as the SQL, then you should be having a good understanding of cloud computing. Because let's be honest, today most of the companies have already migrated their resources and data pipelines on these major platforms like Azure and AWS majorly. So if you are aware about EMR, it is like a Hadoop cluster in AWS. That service will provide you a full Hadoop ecosystem on cloud. You can also have the data pipelines in Azure, for example. So there are different tools like Azure Data Factory, Azure Synapse Analytics for building your ETL pipelines, as well as the data analytics platform in Azure. And the most important topic I forgot, you should be having a good understanding of any of the SQL database. SQL database means a relational database. So either it could be a MySQL database or PostgreSQL or SQL Server. No matter what it is, but you should be having a good understanding of how we can process the data which is present in a relational database. Because in the most of the data pipelines, there is a highly chance that SQL database is a source for your data pipeline. So for example, your data is in SQL Server and you have to build a framework so that millions of users can query on that data. So what you will do is you will build a data pipeline, you will use a scope utility. So it is like a data transfer tool to transfer data in batch manner. So you can use scope to import that data and dump it into HDFS, which is a distributed storage system, and it's native storage for Hadoop. And you can build Hive tables or Impala tables so that many users can query on that table, and it will take a benefit of distributed computing, and you will get a results in seconds. So that is the power of distributed computing. So I know that these technical terms most of you might not be aware of, but don't worry, we have covered it all in our Hadoop full course. So just go to it and let me know in the comments if you face any difficulties. So these were just the basic things what you need to enter the data world. But now let's talk about some of the advanced topics that you should be aware of if you want to shine from rest of the data engineers. So those are the two topics. The first one is NoSQL database, and the second one is real-time data analytics. So let's talk about the first one, NoSQL databases. So NoSQL databases is the next big thing in the business right now, because relational databases, no doubt, they are good for analytics, and if you are dealing with transactions, then OLTP system is very good. But if you're talking about a very highly available and highly scalable solution, then NoSQL database is the best choice. And it has different types like column-based database, document-based database, and the graph database. So in the agile development world, where your schema will eventually evolve, at that time, relational databases has a very disadvantage because it has their constraints, and you cannot do many things with relational databases because the schema would be fixed, and to change your schema, that would be a very headache, and you cannot do that every sprint. So that purpose, NoSQL databases are very popular nowadays because of their flexible schema and how you can store huge amounts of data with minimal administrative tasks. So if you know any of the NoSQL databases like Cassandra, MongoDB, or any graph database like Gremlin or the Neo4j, no matter what, you should just have the basic understanding of NoSQL. And the last thing is real-time data streaming. So there are multiple scenarios, like the data coming from any IoT device, or the data coming from any temperature sensor, or the sensor which are attached to your vehicle. So these data will come in real time. So till now we have talked about the data which is in stationary form. But what happens is, whenever your data is coming from any web logs or any sensors that we just talked about, you have to process that data in real time. So for example, so if you go to Amazon and search for any item, they will just analyze that data in real time and give you the product recommendations. So that section totally backed by the real time data analytics. And these big companies uses tools like Apache Kafka to process that data in real time and give you the desired output. And many frameworks like recommendation engines or an autonomous vehicle. So these applications are totally based on these tools. And there is also a last one, which is data warehousing. So data warehousing means a place where all your data coming from different sources comes together in a raw format, and then you can use any ETL tool like Informatica, Tableau, Alteryx to process that data and build dashboards using Microsoft Power BI, again Tableau, Kibana, to visualize data in the more interactive way. So that is also important aspect, and that is a base for every data engineer. So you may ask, where I can learn all these things? So don't worry, we are coming with a new course where I will teach you Apache Spark with Python. So where we can cover all about the distributed processing, some Python knowledge which will be required to build a simple Spark application, and definitely Apache Spark to process your data in batch mode, in real time, and as well as we will also learn about the mllib library where you can apply machine learning algorithms on top of your data. So if you are interested, just stay tuned and subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.